she's walking down the street, lying to every eye she meets. Is it okay for you?
So you want to make this kind of like informal?
Yeah, I don't know if it's informal or...
So you're gonna...
Yeah, we are here.
It's okay.
Just woke up. And
yeah, don't worry.
I was slammed last night because I didn't think you. I think I was over, and we partied till 3 or 4 this morning.
Yeah, so good for you.
I understand. She woke me up. And
yeah,
said,
was it funny?
Was it funny? Yeah, it was interesting.
Was interesting. Okay. Nice to meet you, Mr. Stone.
Hey, how are you, Dale?
Fine. You?
I'm okay, except I'm smashed this morning.
Yeah, that's. I realized this.
Up till 4 o'clock this morning in Rome, partying.
Doing what?
Going to this gala affair for... they had JFK revisited, the 4-hour version, the 2-hour version, and they had Kazakh.
Look.
Another documentary I was involved with as an interviewer of the president of Kazakhstan, Nur-Sultan. Very interesting look at a powerful new country. It's the heart of Eurasia between China and Russia, which is a key center for the future. He's an important man who's been around for 40 years in power. He worked his way from a communist union leader, steelworker, to the top of the party. He was under Brezhnev, then he moved into Gorbachev times, post-communism, and then he moved through Yeltsin times, up to Mr. Putin. And China's changes too, because Kazakhstan is right in the center between China and Russia. And the United States wants a piece of Kazakhstan too. They have some business interests there.
And now you're in Italy.
Yeah, I'm in Italy.
Each country has its problem. I don't know if someone told you about our situation right now.
A little bit.
We just had the elections in Rome, for instance, in Milan, in Naples, some of the major cities of Italy. We are in a post-lockdown, very tough lockdown that we had. Now we have demonstrations of a minority, but it's a quite strong minority, of no vax, no green pass.
In the US, it's a usual division. 70%, I think, went along with the vaccine.
Mm-hmm.
I guess 30%, not sure, but they don't want it. They think it's some kind of alien or un-Christian invasion or something.
Yeah.
Why? Because people have ignorance, are ignorant of the... And that's always going to happen. I don't know the history of vaccines well, but certainly ignorance is like people don't want to try new ways because they're scared of them. They always...
And they're scared of the vaccine.
Laps back, yeah. Putting the needle in your arm scares some people. They just say, oh, no, what are they going to put aliens into my bloodstream? And they fear it. Fear is the enemy. It's a mind killer. It doesn't let you think.
And is it true that you had 4 injections of the vaccine?
Yeah, well, that's
4.
Not planned. That was not planned. I was in Russia working with their scientists.
So you had 2 Sputnik?
They had two Sputniks there
at the very
beginning
Pfizer.
Of the vaccine. And then when I tried to get into the EU, they wouldn't let me in.
Because the Russian vaccine is not recognizing
they would not recognize it. So I had to get 2 more Pfizers.
And so how do you feel?
Fine, but except I need a booster now for the Pfizer. It's been about 6 months.
So you believe in the strength
Absolutely.
Of the vaccine?
Yeah, I've taken vaccines all my life, you know, from polio on. I started in the polio age. I don't know about you. But
in Russia, right, today Putin decided to close for 1 week the no-essential works to stop the infections that are going on.
Yeah, because Russians also, they're very slow, they're ignorant of the vaccine, and a lot of them don't want to get it. I don't know what they're waiting for. They're waiting for maybe Pfizer to come to Russia or something like that. A lot of Russians don't have trust in Russian products, so they put their trust in Western products. And also, honestly, people who don't have a lot of education are scared of it, too. It's a worldwide problem.
Mainly it's a problem of education. Education helps to fight fear.
Exactly. Africa, India, there's going to be tremendous resistance. It will take a few years for this vaccine to get in. I'm sure they'll have oral medication pretty soon.
You're supposed to be a sort of expert in conspiracy.
Oh.
Yeah, I don't know. It's sort of joke since you, with your job, I mean, you investigate a lot of very famous cases.
Yeah, I'm interested in it, especially when you murder a political leader who's crucially important to the world.
Obviously. Talking about COVID, a lot of people think they argument with conspiracy theories around the COVID. That is made to make the big pharma's richer. What do you think about this?
My son has been on that path for almost a year.
And
yes, he's very consistent. Obviously, I don't agree with him. You know, you need a pretty big imagination to doubt. People say Bill Gates, you know, is part of the evil and all that stuff. I don't see it. I think Gates is motivated by goodwill. I think money is important to him too, yes. But he's working very hard on several fronts with research money, his own money. He's also working on green projects. He put enormous amount of money into renewables, and it hasn't worked out for him in terms of the productivity of it. So, I mean, he's a man who's trying different things, and I think he's admirable. We have to get off this fear of conspiracies, and they want to vaccinate the entire population, it's in order to control it. I mean, yeah, that, to me, is absurd. Mind control fears, you know, that you're going to change if you...
Yeah.
A lot of people in America have that fear that somehow this thing is going to get into my mind. I've had 4 shots, almost a year and a half. Do I look like I'm under somebody else's control?
What's the role of the media on all of this?
Well, the media has wasted a lot of time talking about pro and anti, and it's obviously the media wants to make money. It's a controversial subject, but it's not really of ultimate importance to the human race. What's important is climate control. What's important is cleaning up our atmosphere. That's the most important issue we have in the world. Mm-hmm. More important than nuclear war.
Yeah, but the media can help in order to understand the relevance
they have
of
to
this.
Understand. I've read so many ignorant articles. I've seen some very good articles, but education, again, we find on these issues that the media, it tends to almost take the easier way out and sensationalize and say, oh, are you pro-vaccine? Are you anti-vaccine? Or do you believe you're going to turn into a zombie? That's much more interesting to the public on mm-hmm. a daily basis, right? It's like a horror film.
I read an article or an interview where you said that media needs bad news.
Yes, you know, I mean, evidently, yes. Have you ever looked at the news as bad news? I mean, mm-hmm. who wants to see the news? If you don't start your day by reading the news, you're better off meditating, getting your own soul.
No, I agree
together.
With you, but the funny thing now is that before, when there was the lockdown, they said, okay, this is just the media that are talking about this COVID stuff, that now the bad news is their demonstration, because in theory, there is a good news, that it is the vaccine.
Yes, I mean, they made a fortune with talking about lockdowns. I hated lockdowns, and I think it was overdone. I really do. I was in California. In California, even worse than the Midwest and mm-hmm. the South, New York and California. The lockdown was overemphasized. The rules were stupid. For example, it was beautiful days in California. Anybody who talked to anybody about the virus knew that it was in the air. It wasn't passed from the skin or mm-hmm. tablecloths. They wouldn't allow us to go to the beaches. They closed the beaches on the key weekends of that summer. I can't believe it, because that was where people had to go to get fresh air. Was always the antidote to me. And the interesting thing in America, if you look at the TV, this football season just started, baseball season, mm-hmm. they've been full. The stadiums have been gradually filled full up with people sitting right next to each other.
It's happening the same thing right now.
There's no incidence of rise in COVID.
I still go to the stadium with the mask.
We're talking about, you know, millions of people that are going into stadiums without masks, and it's working. I think the governments react to the media. Governments impose strict lockdowns because it plays politically. It looks good in the media. You have to do something, right? That's the problem with politics and media, because you have to react to media. They make you, they force you. Oh, we need a law for this, and they push, and then you pass the law, and then 2-3 years later you think it's a lousy law. But that tends to be the direction of the media.
Probably the problem is the measure of...
They all tend to overreact because it pays. It's better to be extreme. Moderation is the hardest position for any politician to have. I admire politicians who have a concept of moderation in their minds.
Like, for instance, who? Biden is moderate enough.
He's okay. He's an older man now. He's been around. There's something wise about being older, mm-hmm. and he suffered a lot in his life, so he's not stupid.
We all hope he's not stupid.
No, he's aware of politics, and they overdid Trump. They hated Trump so much that they made him into
Trump wasn't moderate.
He was not moderate. They made him into a madman, and they overplayed him, and they tired us out with him. And the reason he lost, I mm-hmm. think, is partly because of overexposure.
We talk about the rule of medias, and what about the rule of artists?
I'd never chase the news. In other words, if you tell me you have a great film about a vaccine, I'm not going to go there.
No, for instance, the priority you said is the climate change.
Yeah, okay. For me. The Green Party in Europe has been a disaster for the world. I'm sure I surprise you, because I'm sure you're pro-green. I think the worst decision Germany made in the last 20 years was to get off nuclear power, and that's what the Green Party did. They have put it, as a result, they've gone to coal mm-hmm. and renewables, and they put the same amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere than they always did. And Germany's a very important country. France is doing very well, cutting its carbon emissions. Sweden, too. But it's amazing that the Green Party is still ignorant of what advanced nuclear power can do. And I'm saying this because I'm doing a documentary. It hasn't come out yet. It's called Solar Power, mm-hmm. and it's about this
on
clean
the climate
energy.
Change.
Yeah, it's about climate change, which is the most important issue for me now, mm-hmm. at my age and your age too, I guess. That's the key. That's the only goal that matters. This is beyond politics. Mm-hmm. This is beyond what you think. This is about scientific fact, like the vaccine. You have to really advance our thinking. We have to get out of our opinions, because we have too many of them. This I found out on my documentary, talking to so many people of our generation who say to me, you know, isn't it dangerous? Isn't there waste? And you have to compare everything to everything. You have to compare coal, you have to compare even renewables. They all have prices to pay. And nuclear has the best record of all in terms of deaths, fatalities, and nothing has happened in the sense except for Chernobyl. That was the only really, and Fukushima, no casualties, but it was a controlled disaster. It was a tsunami that really killed the people. Nobody else got killed except evacuees, people who were evacuated without any preparation from their homes. It was a usual fuck-up of a government.
Right. Do you use social media?
I do.
Social network.
Unfortunately, I do, but I'm moderate about it.
You are moderate. Is it possible to be moderate on social network?
I owe a lot to the internet, a lot. I mean, a lot of the things I've learned in the last 20 years have come through the internet, through alternate journalism, what they call fake news. Yeah, okay. They say fake news, but there was an older expression for it. It was called lies.
Is it also a toxic place?
It's a toxic place. If you're on the internet all day, I mean, you're going to go nuts. I mean, you can't live in that world. It's a world you visit. You take the information you can, and you have a...
But not all the information that you find on the internet are correct, are right.
Of course not. And we're assuming you're intelligent enough to figure
it
out.
Yeah, yeah. No, I mean, I'm not talking about me personally.
Yeah,
I'm talking about...
No, I mean, there's a lot of stupid stuff, yes, and it gets around, but it's not... going to last. Now, you can say the Trump phenomenon was based on that, but on the other hand, there were other issues, you see. It was the main party, the Democrats, who really had tired out America with the Obama administration. Whatever reason, you know, they got sick of it, and they went toward this outsider, as the Americans tend to go for the outsider. Think back to George Bush, and think back to the people like... They've always had third-party candidates. They tend to like the outsider. That's why he won. And, of course, it turned into a nightmare for a lot of people, and they finally got rid of him. But he's promising to come back. I don't think he will make it back.
Probably. Do you have the debate about the cancel culture in the USA?
Of course.
In Italy, we're not sure that we have this debate.
Well, you're better off without it. I mean, to be canceled for some nonsense mistake you made. I mean, everybody deserves a second or third chance. It's not like a world that has so quick to judgment. And so many people have been hurt, very badly hurt, their careers disrupted by, I think, very harsh Puritan reactions.
Usually all these debates, they start from the USA and then we...
Is that right?
And we had...
The Italian culture, for me, has always been the one most forgiving and one of the most generous. I come to Italy often just for holiday because the people are generous. Now, you may not agree, but I'm talking as an outsider. They're very happy people. They're much happier than the French, but...
Okay.
No, I'm half French.
Oh, it's okay, it's okay.
You know I'm half French.
This is still the image that you have of Italy, by the way.
It's not an image, it's my experience.
All right.
People are kind and generous and enjoy life. The food is great. Yes, everyone has beefs, disappointments, anger. But you have... I'm comparing it to everywhere else I've been in the world.
So we are still better than other?
Yes, I think you have a wonderful culture, old culture, a lot of meaning.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Diego.
And I hope you'll relax after the party.
Yeah. I hope you got what you want.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Bye.